Hello, I'm Kathy, the Arty Mummy. Welcome to Easy Acrylic Valentine Art Tutorial Part 2. You make my heart flutter. Butterfly Valentine's Day painting. Now, I hope you enjoyed yesterday's beginning, and here we are up to this part. If you didn't catch that, I'll leave a link to it. I'm not up to end screens yet, I'm afraid, but I'll get there. I'll leave a link to the other video in the description of this one, and let's get straight into it. So if you go to my Facebook page, where there is also a link in the description, you'll find printable images there that you can use for traceables. So, and my beautiful girls wanted to have a go at these today, so I let them have a go. They did their own artistic thing. This one belongs to Aaliyah. She's 6. I think she did a beautiful job of that one. And Kiara made this one with a lovely couple of flowers, and she did both butterflies, and they both used the iridescent paints. So unfortunately Kiara poked a hole in hers, but I'm gonna fix that up for her, and she's really pleased with how that came out. Anyway, Kiara's 9, Aaliyah's 6. I think they did really well. So once you've got your image traced onto your tracing paper, you can either go over the entire back part of it with chalk and transfer it that way, or the way that I like to do it is with some, I usually use charcoal, but this time I've used graphite because my charcoal has gone to God. I usually say don't use graphite, because if you're using lighter colours you can have trouble covering it if it gets anywhere that you don't want it to be in the end. I made that mistake once with a canvas and ended up adapting it. And we've got this one here as well. I just traced the words and did them with a Sharpie marker, permanent marker, so that I got that full sort of printed kind of look. I will probably still use this on the artwork because I'm pretty hopeless at getting that neat with a paintbrush for lettering. So I'm afraid my calligraphy is not very up to scratch with a paintbrush, so I have my Sharpie permanent marker that we'll do that bit with. Now, so the first thing I'm going to do is just arrange them on the canvas how I'd like to see them in the finished painting. And I'm pretty happy with that. And let's get started. So we're just going to use a firm pressure with a pencil, pen, any kind of pointy, not too pointy object, but pointy enough that you can be definite with it, and just put nice firm pressure on all your lines just to make sure that you get a nice transfer there. I'm going to speed up through this bit. You can pause it somewhere here, get your own down, and make sure that you've got some nice lines. Make sure if you can't manage to hold it nice and still, tape it down on one side at least, so that you can still lift up and have a look and make sure that you haven't missed anywhere, and make sure that you've got all those lines down so that we're ready to paint on them when we've got the transfer done. Okay, so once you're happy that your butterflies are transferred onto the paper, we'll do this one after. We'll paint our butterflies first. We just needed to have that there just to make sure that we're placing the butterflies properly with the text. Just I didn't want to have things ending up sort of too close or oddly placed. Pop those aside now. You get a nice little brush and just try and find my lines. Don't worry if yours is not perfect, neither will be mine. So we're just going to use those lines as a guide. First to admit I'm blind as a bat, so hence the just a guide. Going to carefully pop that outline in. So just apply a tiny bit extra pressure.
go. I think we've got that one pretty okay. Large one. I'm just using this as a reference in case I get lost. I think this one's come out a little bit clearer than the first one. So, okay, up. Struggling with that line a bit. Okay, we can work with it. You'd think someone that paints a lot would have a steady hand, wouldn't you? Usually. The lovely thing about not having them straight on to you, as in with both wings out evenly spaced, is one, they look much more natural like this, and two, you can get away with a whole lot more. They don't have to be exactly symmetrical because you're looking at each wing from a different angle, and you're even, in this case, looking at the bottom of one wing and the top of another. So you don't need to be too fussy with it. We're putting a few layers of paint on these anyway, so. Oops. Never mind. That's it. Doesn't have to be perfect. Let me just bring that down to there. So make sure that you keep your paint with plenty of moisture in it so that pretty much if your brush starts to grab or starts fading a bit, you definitely need to reload. Okay. So we're that far now. If there's anything you feel like that you really should touch up, you can go ahead and do that now before we move on to the other, move on to some colours. So that much done, let's play with some colours. I love this colour, quinacridone magenta and titanium white. And we're just going to get a nice pink. Now I've chosen a warm blue and a pink because they're complementary on the colour wheel. They're opposite to each other. So these colours should really pop really nicely on the canvas. Begin on this part here. The titanium white will also help with coverage of what's underneath, because some of these colours can be quite transparent. We're not going to worry too much if we go over some of our black lines, because we're going to do some fun things with this in a little while. So I'm just going to basically start by putting a base coat down of just some nice colour. You can have some fun with it, put some gradient in there. Slightly different shades. Let's try to do on one wing what you do to the other. So we've got this section here. Oh, we missed a bit. Silly me. I'll just let that dry for a moment before I go near it with the pink, or I'm going to end up with a bit of muddy. Grab a little bit more of the magenta. Just pull that up there into that wet paint. It's basically getting some really nice coverage in here. I love that colour. Just blending up with some little bit of white on my brush. So this piece here, what have we got going on here? We've got this one here in this nice lighter pink. Going down to a little bit darker at the base. Oh, I don't know if you can hear that, but I've got very light rain happening, which is just fantastic. If you make any little mistakes, the beautiful thing about acrylic paint is that you can go over it. Thank you. wait long enough for that. If you end up contaminating your brush at all, just go ahead and give it a clean. Don't worry about that patch for a minute and then go back to it later. So I'm just using the pink and the white to just make some variations in tone between where the different sections kind of meet each other. Just make it a little bit more interesting. And I'm just going to go ahead and paint like every second section of this wings. Just with the magenta and a bit of titanium. Darker down there. So where they meet, we're just creating a little bit of contrast and using the titanium white to give it opacity, make it so we can't see the flowers through the wing. And to a large degree, I'm just letting this mix on the canvas. It's picking up a bit more of what I'm after colour wise. And just popping it in there. Make this the one pink as well. Beautiful. Let's do some dots. Just be careful if you're working on a flat surface like I am, not to lean your hand on your wet paint. It's a good idea to just pop your finger down somewhere that you know your paint's dry and just use that to steady your hand rather than leaning your whole wrist against it. And you see why you didn't have to be overly careful with the black. Just wanted to make sure that we didn't lose that tracing that we did and that we're able to see it clearly so that we can get some nice clean work down to begin with. I'm just going to grab a little bit of my ultramarine blue and see if I can't get a pretty purple. Oh, that is pretty. It's a lovely mauve-y kind of colour. Maybe a little bit darker. Get a bit more of it. So I don't want to run out. So that looks very dark. I quite like that. Very pretty darkish mauve. And again, you can play with the tones a little bit. A little bit of blending in there. And again, on the other wing, we're going to do the same thing. Don't worry if you lose your black lines a little bit. If we entirely leave them in there, they'd probably be a little bit harsh by the end of this, because I want it to be very soft and easy to look at. Nice complementary colours. Just really pretty. Don't worry about how it looks at this stage, just enjoy the therapy of painting. Painting is my therapy. It just makes me so much calmer and more relaxed. Helps me keep my sanity with all my little darlings. Go a little bit lighter in that middle bit, again for a bit of contrast. Just want to touch up that pink along here. Purple, don't we? go back and do a little bit of purple and white. Just mixing as you go. Just painting a pretty butterfly. It doesn't have to be exactly matching colours anywhere, as long as you're staying with that beautiful pink and purple in various tones and shades, it will end up looking beautiful. Mix up that very light pink again and just do these little triangles in here. Make sure you've got enough paint on your brush. It's probably a bit too much. And just use the shape of your round brush to get into those little sharp edges. I'm going to put another layer on those dots. Some of them went a little bit muddy or didn't quite cover. Pick up some of my dark mauve colour that I've got here and just add a little bit of black to it. Just to make sure we don't run out, let's mix up some more. So fairly equal parts of magenta and blue, with just the tiniest touch of black, and we should have an almost black, very, very deep purple. Just won't be quite as harsh as going the full carbon black. Might have to get two coats onto this. Morning, my sweetheart. Good morning, my baby.
Oh, I'm thirsty.
Is that why you're up in the middle of the night, my darling?
Yeah.
Okay.
I wake up in the night and sleep.
So Tyler's back in bed. going with this dark, dark purple. Love the sound of that gentle rain. Just the lightest sprinkle, but gosh, it's good. I'm just going to go over the body with just that same purple. I'm just kind of leaving a little bit of light on the ridge of each one of those. Parts of the body, more sections. Now we're going to let that dry and pick up some more blue. So we're going to kind of symbolize the his and hers with these two butterflies. So we've got a contrasting blue to the sky here, which is nice. So what we do to one side, we're going to do to the other. So we get nice matching wings, especially on this guy, because he's got both wings facing the same direction to us. Touch darker. And I see a little mistake that I've got here, so I'm just going to fix that up while I'm there. Again, we're just going to alternate a little bit. Thank you. that again. I see the beauty of acrylic is if you make a mistake, it really doesn't matter a lot. Just paint over it. Some aqua. That's nice. I do love aqua and purple and aqua and blue as well. Very pretty together. Some of that purple. because it doesn't really matter what colours or tones you put on there, variations of. Just stick within that same palette and you pretty much can't go wrong. We definitely want this one to be more in the blues. We can make any combination of mauve and pale blue just to get some nice changes in colour. It's still staying within that little limited palette. Do that again. Actually, I think I quite like that colour for that little bit at the front of the wings. Yes, I do like that better. Although I might change it again before I'm done. We'll see. Our main focus at the moment is to get just a nice base coat down on all of your butterfly wings. Mixing up a slightly lighter blue there. It doesn't need to look like any particular butterfly. Whoever you imagine it to be. continue with the colours that I have on the inner part of the wing. And a little bit of black again. We want more blue than black though, just a tiny bit of the black. Tiny bit of the black and a lot of blue. Isn't so harsh as black. second coat just makes it pop. I'm afraid I'm going to have to call it a night. I haven't been very well at all today, and it's about as much sitting as I'm able to do at the moment.
So those of you who have been around for a while will know that I have some kind of unknown autoimmune condition that makes my bones hurt, and I do my best for you guys, so I hope you've enjoyed tonight's tutorial, and we will continue tomorrow. So thank you so much for joining me. I hope you've had a really relaxing time painting along with me tonight, and I will see you tomorrow. Thanks so much again. Bye for now.